With that note, ladies and gentlemen, now it's time to welcome the next speaker. But quickly before I get into the next speaker is a journey of what he holds and what he brings to the Indian consumers. 2021 marks the 25th anniversary since Hyundai entered India and literally drew itself into the hearts of millions of Indian consumers. Delivering the special address, we have a very special gentleman who's always like a spark when it comes to reimagining future for our country. Mr. Tarun Garg, Director, Sales, Marketing and Service India, Hyundai, taking us through the long journey from the first car, the Hyundai Santro, the latest best-selling SUV, Hyundai Creta. From a hatchback to sedan, SUV, he is here to give us all the answer Hyundai has done over the last 25 years. Hi Tarun, good afternoon to you and welcome to the PIT CMO Summit.
Very nice talking to you and thank you for having me here.
Very, very delighted to have you here. Thank you so much for joining us. You know, there is so much that I want to first start with questioning you, but I will wait to hear from you. And it's lovely seeing you virtually after a really long time. And let's hear from you first. What is that we're celebrating Hyundai 25 years in India, and what more in terms of plan or future that you have in mind that you can share to all our viewers, and after which we'll take on the Q&A.
Yeah. It has been an incredible journey, and I request Sagar to have my presentation on the screen. So can we have the presentation, Sagar? So, ladies and gentlemen, this is about Hyundai Motor India's 25 years in India. And can we have the next slide? So we started in 1996, you know, when the groundbreaking ceremony happened and the factory construction started. And more importantly, you know, India was Hyundai's first global venture. So you can understand that it has been very, very special for us. And we set up our manufacturing facility in Sriperumbudur in Chennai. And of course, now we are into the 25th year. Can we have the next slide, please? So you would remember that Santro was India's most loved car, you know, the tall boy Santro. And we introduced it in September 98. In 16 years, Santro was there. We sold 1.86 million units, domestic plus export. It was hugely successful. And along with Santro, of course, came with Shah Rukh Khan. And you remember that was a time when Shah Rukh Khan was making his way to superstardom in Bollywood. So Hyundai's stardom in India coincided with Shah Rukh Khan's stardom in India as well. So until date, you know, he continues to be our brand ambassador. So we have had some 25 years, which we can look very fondly to. Yeah, can we have go to the next slide, please? So this is the next slide shows this sprawling plant. We have two integrated plants, in fact, spanning 536 acres, you know, near Chennai. So we have, of course, passenger vehicles as well as powertrains. And, you know, and we have been producing vehicles. And we can go to the next slide, where you'll be surprised to know that we are working 294 days a year, 294 days a year, three shifts and 6 days a week. So I think that is the level of precision and that is the level of responsive manufacturing we have. Obviously, it requires stringent process monitoring and, of course, IT-enabled preventive maintenances because we cannot afford any lapses out there. We have 5,000-plus quality checks and, of course, 900-plus foolproof systems. So we are basically manufacturing precision, quality, accuracy, and flexibility to meet demand. I think that has been the mantra at Hyundai. Next slide, please. Of course, it's all about automation. We have 650 plus fourth generation robots and a 14,000 plus workforce. More importantly, along with the robust manufacturing technology, we also have flexibility. I think that is very, very important. And in the last 25 years of rich experience, we are moving towards self-reliance, 100% self-reliance. We are very motivated by Prime Minister's mantra of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Of course, energetic millennial minds drive you know, our precision. And we have 50 plus data scientists on the shop floor. I think that is very important. because we are really using data to make sure that we are able to improve efficiencies. And all in all, we can say that the humans, machine, and processes work in perfect harmony at the Hyundai plant. Next slide, please. Of course, environment is extremely important. And we are very proud to say that it's a very environment friendly manufacturing facility. We have a strong commitment to care for employees as well as environment. So we have a regenerative thermal oxidizer. We have rainwater harvesting. We have a storage capacity of over 335,000 kiloliters. And we have a reserve for 112 days, you know. And of course, green belt, 40 acres of green belt with over 20,000 trees. And of course, recycled water for landscaping. Next slide, please. Of course, our manufacturing roadmap is all about being future ready. So we take care of, you know, its integration of intelligence, digital and analytics. And if I take, you along the journey, 2012, we had this comprehensive ERP where we had the SAP and the global quality management systems. 16, we were the digital factory with assembly, digital simulation, line monitoring systems. And of course, 2030 is only 9 years away. And we are industry 4.0 manufacturing with artificial intelligence and digital learning. Next slide, please. So market commitment has to be very, very strong. And we are committed to creating sustainable products and services customers to enrich the mobility experience. So we have an investment of $4 billion plus, 27 products, 27 models, 9.6 million customers. And of course, we give employment to 250,000 direct and indirect manpower. I think that is extremely important. So basically, sustainable business expansion in line with our global vision for together for a better future. Of course, we are number one, India's number one passenger car exporter, and make in India is our mantra. I think that is extremely, extremely close to our heart. Next slide, please. So if we see the historical sales, domestic and exports, you would see that we have had a very strong sustainable market share. More importantly, you know, we have really managed. In fact, last year was our 24th year, and I'm very proud to say that we had the highest ever market share since inception in 2020. So we had a market share of 17% in 2020. That means actually we are young, we are strong, and of course we are raring to go. We have also been the largest exporter since inception. So we have really been able to have a balance between domestic and export, because I believe that is very important to showcase to the world the strength of Indian manufacturing. So I think that is extremely, extremely important. We can now come to the next slide. This talks about, of course, our strength across segments. And as I said earlier, we started with the entry compact, and then we have moved. And the important thing about Hyundai has been our ability to spot the customer trends, you know, whether it was through the i10 or whether it was through the i20, then 2000 through the Creta, when we saw a climate emerging for the more than 4 meter SUV. And of course, very proud to say that in 2020, Hyundai became the India's number one, the leader in SUV segment. So it's a very prestigious segment, and they're holding a market share more than 26%. And the share of SUV segment in the industry has moved to now 33%. So it is the most prestigious segment. And we have four models, the Creta, the Venue, the Tucson, and the Santa Fe, holding our foot in the SUV segment. And of course, we have now announced the launch of the Alcazar 7-seater SUV with a global debut. The next slide, please. So the strength of Hyundai, of course, lies in a wide range of options that we give to the customers, whether it is, of course, about the body type, compact, sedan, SUVs, or the powertrains. We are offering 5 automatic options to the customers, whether it is IMT, AMT, CVT, AT, or DCT. Then we are having a petrol BS6, diesel BS6, CNG BS6, turbo BS6, and of course the Kona Electric. So the whole idea is that we want to be in the consideration set of each and every person requiring a four-wheel mobility in India. I think that is extremely important for us. We believe that customer is the king, and our job as an OEM is to offer him options, and then he can decide as per his driving habits, as per his needs, what is the option he's looking for. Next slide, please. Of course, what is very important is the market acknowledgement. So we have the most modern product lineup. Best customer service, very important. JD Power, number one in CSI in 17, 18, and 19. Of course, we were number one in SSI as well in 19. We have had some Manufacturing Excellence Awards HMC in 17 and 18. And of course, our endeavor has always been to be the most beloved and trusted brand in the Indian market. Next slide, please. We are, of course, a brand with a cause. I think we are very proud of that. And we are working with the government of India in a most humble way on various aspects. If I talk about education, we have been supporting industrial training, car donations, tuition centers. If I talk about community development, water camp, drinking RO systems, pond rejuvenation, dream village project, art and culture, happy move, skill development, women empowerment, in terms of health, blood donation campaigns, of course, CPRs. We can move to the next slide. We're looking at roads, we understand that India has a notorious reputation of, having the most fatalities in the world. So we are working closely with the government to have CCTV surveillance, traffic marshals, awareness camps, be the better guy campaigns, 120 street light maintenance, emergency response teams, quiz on road safeties, tree plantations in terms of environment protection, of course, corporate social activities, mall contact program, others, disaster relief. So a lot of activities, basically, we strongly believe in brand with a cause. I think that is the mantra we believe in. We can go to the next slide. Of course, COVID, we understood that COVID was a pandemic which required all of us to come together. So we worked very closely, not only with the central government by giving a contribution to the PM Relief Fund of 7 crore rupees, but also to the Tamil Nadu CM Relief Fund of 5 crore rupees. Also, we have worked with various states, in terms of 3-ply masks, hand sanitizers, PPE kits, dry ration kits, whether it was Maharashtra, Haryana, Delhi and Tamil Nadu. The whole idea was to really work with communities and make sure that we come out of this pandemic as soon as possible. We can now come to the next slide. Of course, continuing on the brand with a cause, we understand that we need to invest continuously in technology and invest into the future. So we are working with IIT Delhi, handing over a Kona to them. Then we are also working in Rajasthan, Chikitsa Vans. We have a satellite clinic in Rajasthan. In terms of road safety, we are going to the resident welfare associations. We have, of course, the Saksham employee generation. We have a Shikshak in terms of education tab distribution. So, the various activities basically to, work very, very closely with it and help them to really grow and to come out of this crisis situation. The whole idea is giving back to society, community development, healthcare, environment, and road safety. We can come to the next slide. This is about the last 20. What about the future direction? So the future direction is on two basic pillars, technology and business. When we talk about technology, we're talking about mobility, whether it is sharing, hailing, and subscription. Electric vehicles, affordable electric vehicles, fuel cell. In fact, that is a very, very important part of our strategy going forward. Connected cars, whether it is data analytics, whether it is membership, whether it is online sales. Autonomous cars, self-driven cars, and artificial intelligence. So basically about mecha, mobility, electric, connected, and autonomous. When I talk about business, it is about the operation and the mindset, whether it is flexibility, agility, and adaptability. Then about customer experience, personalized, unique, and differentiated. The strategic business management, insightful, informed, and data-driven. And of course, the corporate responsibility in terms of being participative and inclusive. I think these are the core values on which we want to move ahead. Next slide, please. Of course, digital excellence has become very, very important. And we are very proud to say that we had introduced a click to buy, which was India's first and only end-to-end online car purchase form. In fact, we had piloted it even before the COVID had struck. And we understand that the customers are changing. And 75% of the buyers are using internet to research before buying a car. And of course, 90% of the automobile sales in India are digitally influenced. So this click-to-buy not only helps the customer in the discovery phase, but also helps him in the consideration phase and as well in the purchase phase. The entire journey it can take care of, whether it is, he wants to check the models, the 3D configurator, he wants to select the dealer's Google ratings, he wants to see the finance options, he wants to have an online sales consultant, video conferencing, online car financing, and of course, ending with a doorstep car delivery. So we had a good response, more than 8 million plus website visitors, 60,000 plus inquiries and 4,000. So it's a one-stop platform for convenient and seamless digital retail journey. We can go to the next slide. Next slide talks about our online service, because we need online service to give an end-to-end customer experience. So whether it is service reservation, whether it is repair order opening, whether it is pickup and drop, whether it is in repair update, whether it is vehicle delivery, whether it is service feedback. The whole idea is to have an integrated end-to-end online service platform. So I think that is what our endeavor is, to give the customer a holistic experience digitally. We can now move to the next slide. So connected cars have been a forte of Hyundai. We started this with Venue in May 19. We moved to the Elantra, the Creta, the Verna, the Tucson, and of course the all-new i20. And the features are continuously increasing. When we had introduced the Venue, there were 39 features. And in the all-new i20, there are 50 features. So far, we have sold more than 100,000 plus vehicles. The whole idea is we have laid a very strong foundation in connectivity space, because we understand that the customers in India, whether it is in terms of internet or mobile usage, they are really looking for connectivity. We believe that their home is their first space, the office is the second space, and the car is the third space. And more so post-COVID, seen that customers are really wanting to stay connected even when they're in the car, and we want to do that. We want to really integrate technology, and we want to do that advancement in technology through voice recognition, IoT, and AI. So that has been the mantra, and you will see more and more connected cars from Hyundai going forward as well. Next slide, please. This slide is very, very close to my heart, because at Hyundai, it is not only about selling the car or servicing the car, but it's about really customer engagement through mobility and lifestyle convenience. And that is where the Hyundai Mobility member comes in. So we are really trying to enhance customer value, basically adding new part and new offers, providing personalized offers, benefits to the customers. So 285,000 plus customers have already registered for these offers. We have our partner brands ranging from Mobis, Drivo, Ghana, Chayos, Yatra, VLCC. So not only are we looking at the in-car benefits, but we're also looking at lifestyle experiences. We're also looking at mobility. The whole idea is to give the customer a personalized, delightful, and unmatched customer experience. We can now move to the next slide. Hey friends, this is about Hyundai's 25 years journey in India. And like I said, it has been a great journey. And we feel that at 25, we are young, we are strongest, and of course, we are full of optimism. We are looking at the future with a lot of faith. We have a strong belief in Atmanirbhar Bharat, and we have strong plans of investments in India, and we would like to really make sure that being a customer-centric organization, we continuously set new benchmarks in terms of customer experience. So thank you for hearing me out, and I'll be happy to take any questions.
Thank you, Tarun. That was very delightful, and indeed, what the best part I like is the last line you said. We are 25, but we're very young. And that's the kind of mindset that the youth of our country also has about Hyundai, because the vehicles that you launch are all youth driven, for people who are 40 but feel at 30 or 20, people at 60 feel at 30 and 40. And that's the mindset from Venue to, all your cars have got so much more about it. And the Creta, oh my God, that car can be an eye catcher among the bunch of ladies as well. That's the kind of car Creta is, standing alone, and the back tail light is the talk of the town when it launched initially in the Auto Expo 2020. I was there and I saw the car, Tarun. It was just so amazing. But I'm going to talk about the electric car Kona. Now, we are all talking about the futuristic India, talking about is India ready for electric vehicles or not? I'm sure you've got this question many times, but I just want to reiterate your thought on this. What is your take about Hyundai playing a big role in electric segment, and is India ready with the infrastructure?
So that's a very important question, and let me answer it. In 2019, when we introduced the Kona, it was India's first SUV electric range of 450 plus kilometers. So the whole idea is somebody has to take the lead. That is what we believed in. you know, you cannot wait for the charging infrastructure to be ready and then say, okay, I'm going to launch. So it's about the chicken and egg story. So we thought that we should take the lead. That is where the Kona came in, and it has received some great response from the customers. So to answer your second part of, you know, I think the movement towards cleaner mobility has begun. And as far as Hyundai is concerned, we have a very strong parent. You know, you would have seen that we have launched the Ioniq brand. Basically, we'll be launching more and more electric cars. Our MD has gone on record to say that we are looking at producing electric cars for more and more mass customers. So probably in 2 to 3 years' time, you'll see more electric cars from Hyundai in the mass mobility space as well. Because we feel that, yes, both activities have to happen parallelly. The infrastructure, the cost of the battery coming down, the products to be launched. So everything has to work in sync. And of course, we are really working very closely with the government of India to really make sure that India's march towards cleaner mobility, you know, is there. Not only in terms of electric cars, but you saw that even BS6, you know, we are one company which not only, you know, made sure that it happened in petrol, but also in diesel, also in turbo, CNG. So we are also studying the hydrogen fuel cell, because this year's budget talked about the mission hydrogen. So we are very excited. As you know that we have an FCEV, you know, next door in Korea and US. So I think there are a lot of options, and we are really looking at cleaner mobility with a lot of optimism, and we will be ready, you know, in due course.
Absolutely. And I can see that, you know, Hyundai is always ready a step ahead for the consumers. For example, first thing is congratulations to you on the fact that i20, the new i20, gets to be the Indian car of the year. And that is a big news in the segment of the car that you got together. But my question talks about existence in Indian market the last 25 years. And where is Hyundai looking in the next 10 years?
This is very good. You know, like I said, and I mean it when I say that we are young. Because I also mentioned a very important data point. You know, all of us normally see a curve, you know, a curve, a growth curve, and then a saturation curve, and maybe a decline curve. But that last year, we had the highest ever market share, you know, in a very, very competitive environment, shows that our passion for growth and our passion for, doing even better stays very well. In fact, we have launched 10 products in the last 24 months. So COVID or no COVID, I think we believe very strongly that it is all about engaging the customers with new products, new technologies, and really not sitting back on the laurels. In fact, my request to all the customers is please demand from us so that we can really raise benchmarks. Because our endeavor is that when the customer demands, all of us are on our toes, you know, and then we have to do better. You asked about the next 10 years. Like I said, we are really looking with a lot of optimism about electric vehicles, autonomous vehicles, connected cars. So the future we understand is there. As to our parent company, HMC, we are really investing a lot into the future. And yes, you will continue to hear from Hyundai. We have just announced the launch of Alcazar, the 7-seater SUV. So,
and that's
hold your breath. I'm sure you're going to love that car as well.
Yes, I've seen the outline of the car. The car looks very, very, very appealing. And I'm sure it's going to be fitting in this business that everybody is wanting to have option. And I think that's exactly where this car is being segmented to be placed. And I think it's going to be a big catch for a lot of Indian consumers. I have one tricky question that I want to ask you, and then probably I'll let you go off. So many variants of Hyundai vehicles, so many types, from hatchback to sedan to MUV. Which is your personal favorite, Tarun? You have to give me an open answer. You cannot be diplomatic here.
Look, my personal favorite is the i20 IMT. I mean, it is a fabulous car, beautiful design. And, you know, it is something which I believe is going to change the way Indians have been driving cars. Because if you see in India, people, you know, generally have been driving manual cars. Probably automatic is about 20 to 25%. And that is where the new technology of IMT has kicked in, where a customer can still have the control over the you know, the gears, but his one leg is free. And in terms of i20, whether it is the mobility, whether it is the flexibility, whether it is design, whether it is the features, I think it is a sexy looking car, and really I love that car. And you know, so my favorite is the i20 IMT.
I totally connect with you. It's a brand new segment, a brand new car, and something that is an eye catcher. Thank you so much, Tarun Garg, for joining us here. It was delightful talking to you, and I can't wait to see person and talk to you more about your brand new 7-seater, because that's another eye catcher that Indian consumers are eagerly waiting for. So thank you again for joining us here, and I wish you great luck in the coming future and the new session as well, and all the best to you. Thank you.
Thank you. A pleasure. Thank you so much.